Vasudeva sutam devam.
Vasudeva sutam devam.
Kamsa chanura mardhanam.
Kamsa chanura mardhanam.
Devaki paramanandam.
Devaki paramanandam.
Krishnam vande jagat gurum.
Krishnam vande jagat guru.
Namostute vyasa vishala buddhe. Pullaravindayata patra netra.
Pullaravindayata patra netra.
Yena tvaya bharata taila purna.
Yena tvaya bharata taila purna.
Prajvalito jnanamaya pradipaha.
Prajvalito jnanamaya pradipaha.
Shubhodaya. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening from wherever you are joining. We have been covering the 17th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. In Sanskrit, in our text, to understand, if you communicate through words, it is susceptible to misinterpretation. And from what angle you are looking at, you start seeing it differently. And that is why in the scriptures, to understand that one, numerology also plays a very dominant role. In numerology, if you go by numerology, there is no contradiction. 1 + 1 is always 2. You can't say it is 3. But if I say one sentence in Sanskrita, from different angle and each word has different interpretation, different meanings, different levels, it opens up and it is susceptible to misinterpretation. In numerology, there is no contradiction. And 17 has a it's a significance, numerological significance is there. 18, I mentioned Bhagavad Gita has 18 chapters. Mahabharata has 18 parvas and Srimad Bhagavatam has 18,000 shlokas, and Mahabharata war was fought for 18 days and with 18 battalions, 11 on Kaurava, 7 on Pandava side, and it's 18 runs through, it conveys the message. And 18, I mentioned previously, 18 is a divine number. Supreme Lord is represented by the number 18. And 18 also, Mahabharata, when Vedavyasa composed that one, he called that one scripture as Jaya. Jaya means victory. Victory, Jaya has a numerological number. Ya is 1, Ja is Kaka Gaganga Cha Cha Ja, 8. 8 and 1 in a reverse way, in the numerology in Sanskrita, it is told reverse, that is 18. Jaya means victory, 18 means victory. Supreme Lord is always victorious. And in Bhagavad Gita concluding shloka, yatra yogeshwara krishno yatra partho dhanurdharah tatra shri vijayo bhuti. Vijaya, jaya, vijaya, highly victorious, that person, one who thinks of the Lord all the time. On the 18 is a divine number. And what is 17? 17 also is a divine number. So 18 represents the Supreme Lord. 17 represents the Lakshmi Tattva. Yesterday in India and Australia and many countries, Varamahalakshmi Vrata celebration was there. In America today, they are celebrating Varamahalakshmi Vrata. And 17 represents the Lakshmi number. 17 is the Lakshmi and 18 is the Supreme Lord. And what about 16? 16 is the number for the individual soul. individual soul is bound by 15 cords. 15 cords are bound. This 16, number 16, individual soul is bound by 15 cords. And as long as this Jiva, this soul, looks at only at this 15, it is bound. 17, Lakshmi Tattva binds the individual soul because this individual soul is happy with 15. The moment the individual soul turns its attention, his attention or her attention towards 18, when 16 turns attention to the 18, 17, Lakshmi Tattva unbinds that soul. So, a 16 moves towards the 18, gets liberated. Lakshmi, she puts the curtain in between. If 16 is happy with 15, and what are those 15? I want to know in Shat Prashno Upanishad. Upanishad, it comes out that quickly read that one. That's the 15 things. The 16 is happy. Most of us are happy with 15. And that is why 17 binds the 16, makes it helpless. It is the coming and going. We have to, if you want to move towards 18, 16, if we have to move, to, has to move towards the 18, and it has to turn its attention. In the only in the English it is there, all roads lead to Rome. In scripture, in spirituality, not all roads lead to Rome. You have to take a right decision. Wrong way, if you are treading, you are bound. You have to tread in a right way. In that Upanishad, it talks about sa prana srijate prana shraddha kham vayu jyoti apa prithvi indriyam manaha annatmanat viryam tapo mantram karma loka lokeshu cha namacham. And this 15, it is talked about in Upanishad. This prana, prana here, it talks about the jiva. Jiva is bound by the 15. First is Shraddha. And in the beginning we talked about Shraddho ayoyam purusho yo Shraddha evasa. I am nothing but bundle of faith. I don't care what the truth is. My parents did, my grandfather did, my religion says, I do that one. I don't care about the truth. I belong to that Shraddha, one faith. It is very difficult to move that one. That faith, I am bound by that faith. I don't want to think outside the box. I want to be happy. I am happy thinking in my own, my family tradition. And I don't care about the truth. One is Shraddha. And that the it is talk about Shraddha. Then second is Kham, the space. We are happy in the existing space. I am happy in Australia. I don't want to, it's the best country. I don't care about, I'm happy in America. I'm happy in India, it's the best place. India is a long history and it's the best place. That is the that place. I am confined to that place. This is the best place. I don't want to move out of this one. Come what may, I don't want to move. That space binds. Come, Vayu, Vayu, that inside, that breathing also. The fresh air, we talk about fresh air, this air. I want to smell this air. Come, and Vayu, that five elements, it talks Vayu and Aapa. This water is the best water. I want to remain here. And Agni, that fire. The fire, the temperature of the sun, maybe from the sun or the from within. And Pritvi, Pritvi and earth. I want to people some get down to this earth. We fight over this earth. And this is my land, this is my land. And though our residence time is 50 years, 70, 80 years, centuries together people are fighting. This is my land, my land. and my land come what may. And we forget, we are here as a temporary, we are on a traveler, we forget about that one. This is my land, I die fighting for that one, my land, my airspace, I fight for that one. And this fuel in the Middle East, fire fuel, this is my, Iran is tapping Oman's natural gas, or Oman is tapping into Iran's natural gas. This fire, this is mine. And this water, we are fighting over the river water. In the Israel and Palestine, fighting over the water. And Pakistan and India, in Nepal and Tibet, they are fighting over the water. Everywhere water. Fighting for the water, water element. These it's six. It's Kham, Vayiu, Aapa, Vayiu, Agni, Aapa, Pritvi, and then Indriyam, our sense organs, legs, the feet. My every morning, I want to have a cup of coffee. Without that, I don't care. I want cup of coffee. My senses are driving me amok. This senses, the senses and mind, my thinking is not changing. And I will talk about in the other class also. And we, when the new phone is released, I want the latest gadget, iPhone 2021 model. Or 2020 model. If a new car is released, I want the latest gadget. I want my computer has become very slow. I want to upgrade the software. I want to have a new television. I want a new fridge. Latest model. Latest. But what about yourself? Are you upgrading yourself? Sorry, I am not interested. Come to yoga class. Sorry, I am not interested. Come to Bhagavad Geeta class. Sorry, I am not interested. This frame, I am happy with the old gadget here, but outside I want to have the latest one. Outside I want to upgrade this mind, I don't want to upgrade myself. We are here to upgrade. Every year we want to upgrade the phone, but what about you? You are right from childhood, your thinking is the same. You haven't changed. That it's another one is binding is mind. And Anna, the food. Food why eat? Every day I want to have pickle. Every day on the side I want to have this one. I want to have this roti. Every day I want to have. Every day I want to have a dessert. Every day I want to have coffee. And I want to have spicy. I want to have more chili. This Anna, it's another binding. It is binding us. We can't get over that one. And whatever we are eating, we say Annat Veeryam. Next is Veerya. I think I'm getting strength if I eat. Every day I have to eat that one. That conception of strength from the food. Annat Veeryam. And Annat Veeryam. And Tapas. Tapas means thinking. It's a deep thinking. Always I deep thinking, same way of my way is the only way. I don't want to change other way, other's opinion. If I'm going heading a wrong way, though I know it's a wrong way, I want to stick to my the TV debate and all. They keep on arguing, though it is foolish, they want to debate only on that one. Tapa and tapo mantra. Mantra, it's a mantra. Mantra means manana. It's a mantra that whatever they repeat again and again, they always use the swearing word. It's a mantra. Though it is wrong, the way in which they speak, they don't want to change. Tapo mantra and karma. My action I am doing, whatever I am doing, I don't want to upgrade. My action is the same one, mediocre. Ordinary action. And loka, my aspiration in my life is the very trivial. My loka, my aspiration, what I want to achieve in my life, it's same mundane. I am that aspiration also trivial. It is another binding, loka and nama. and Loka, and the 15th one is Nama. I want that name. And if somebody says, Rajendra, your class is hopeless, I am so upset. I think myself as Rajendra. Once I am gone, Rajendra name is still here, somebody will take up that one. But I associate myself with that name. And if somebody calls that person, you are Varun, you are useless. So upset, I have gone into depression. I think I am Varun. Why I have to think? I am bound by the name. And he called me in front of everyone, an idiot. I want to take a revenge. I associate myself only with that name. Who gave that name? I did not have that name when I came. After few days I was born, my parents called me. And I start associating myself with that name, thinking that I am that one. I am so attached to my name. These 16, number 16 Jiva is bound by these 15 cords. Who binds that one? 17 binds. Lakshmi binds. And the how to get rid of this one. And the only way you had to 16 has to turn its attention to 18. When the 16 turns its attention to the 18, Lakshmi, the 17 unbinds us. This 17th chapter, what Bhagavad Geeta we are talking about, and how Lakshmi Tattva binds us, and the 15 cords in the broad classification of three gunas, Sattva, Rajas and Tamas. In the name of three gunas, these 15 ropes, she is binding us. And this chapter, it is talking about slowly you are making aware that 17 is binding us. Many times we are happy being bound. After many lives, Bahunam Janmanam Ante Vasudeva, and after many lives, they realize, 16 realizes, and only I want 18. 60, these 15 never gives me lasting happiness. I want 18. Bahunam Janmanam Ante Vasudeva. Vasudeva. After that, the many lives, that 16 starts looking for 18, then 17 removes the curtain and unbinds that one. And we have covered up to the 14th. 14th partially we covered. Repeat the shloka up to the 14th. Arjuna uvacha. Ye shastra vidimusrajya. Yajante shraddhayanvitaha. Tesham nishtha tu ka krishna. Sattvamaho rajastamaha. Shri Bhagavan uvacha. Trivida bhavati shraddha. Dehi nam sa svabhavaja. Satviki rajasi chaiva. Tamasi cheti tam shrunu. Sattvanurupa sarvasya. Shraddha bhavati bharata. Shraddha mayoyam purusho. Yo yashraddha eva sa. Yajante satvika devan. Yaksha rakshansi rajasa. Pretan bhuta ganaschanye. यजन्ते तामसा जनाः
यजन्ते तामसा जनाः
अशास्त्रविहितं घोरम्
अशास्त्रविहितं घोरम्
तप्यन्ते ये तपो जनाः
तप्यन्ते ये तपो जनाः
दम्भ अहंकार संयुक्ताः
दम्भ अहंकार संयुक्ताः
कामराग बलान्विताः
कामराग
कर्षयन्त शरीरस्थम्
कर्षयन्त शरीरस्थम्
भूतग्रामा अचेतसा मां चैवान्त शरीरस्थम्
तान् विद्या असुरनिश्चयान्
आहारस्त्वपि सर्वस्य त्रिविधो भवति प्रियः यज्ञस्तपः तथा धानम्
तेषां वेद इमां शृणु
आयुस्सत्वं बलारोग्य
सुखप्रीतिविवर्धनाः
रस्या स्निग्धा स्थिरा हृद्या
आहारा सात्विकप्रियाः
कट्वा आम्ला लवण अति उष्णा तीक्ष्णरुक्षा विदाहिनः
आहारा राजसस्येष्टा
दुःखशोकमयप्रदाः यातायामं गतरसं
पूतिपर्युषितं चयत्
उच्छिष्टमपि चामेध्यम्
भोजनं तामसप्रियम्
अपलाकाङ्क्षिभिर्यज्ञो
विधिदृष्टो य इज्यते
यष्टव्यामेवेति मनः
समाधाय स सात्विकः
अभिसन्दाय तु फलम्
डम्बार्थमपि चैवयत्
इज्यते भरतश्रेष्ठ
तं यज्ञं विद्धि राजसम्
विधिहीनम् असृष्टानम्
मन्त्रहीना अदक्षिणम्
श्रद्धाविरहितं यज्ञम्
तामसं परिचक्ष्यते
देवद्विजगुरो प्राज्ञम्
पूजनं शौचमार्जवम्
ब्रह्मचर्या अहिंसा च
शारीरं तप उच्यते
देवद्विजगुरो दिस् वि टच्ड अपॉन स्टार्टेड ऑन दिस श्लोका द तपस इन द थ्री फॉर्म्स इन द बॉडी लेवल टॉकिंग लेवल एंड मेंटल लेवल एंड फिजिकल लेवल इन द आसना व्हाट वी आर डूइंग इट इज ऑल्सो एस टाइप ऑफ तपस to able to the so that do the asana in the physical level so that you can endure the pain from the physical level. Body starts cooperating with you to do the higher possibilities in your life. Asanas, what you are doing, it's also tapas. And here it is talking about in the physical level devadvijaguru prajnam, and it's a bow down to the divine beings. and divine beings and its supreme lord and one this unseen thing behind seen one no, it's not thinking that what I see that alone I believe. Many things we don't see and we experience that one. What we see that alone is not truth. Behind also, beyond that also, there are truths. And we have to remember that one, not to narrow our vision, saying that if I see that one, I believe. Many things beyond perception, things happens. And that is Deva. It's a divine, like sun, the season changes. Why season changes? Who is changing this one? Rain comes. Who is controlling that one? It is not our wind. Wind blows or sun shines and Agni, that fire burns and water flows. Everything goes according to some rule. Without any rule, nothing can work. And company makes a rule saying that at 9 o'clock I have to be at work. So when the company makes a rule, everyone makes sure that we come 9 o'clock to work. But when this entire system, it is the now the spring season, it's about to happen, the flower starts blossoming. Who told these flowers, this is a springtime, it's a time for you to blossom? Who is that? Who is talking to that intelligence in the plant? There is an intelligence in the plant, it starts blossoming. In the autumn time, it starts dropping the leaves. Who told that it's a autumn time? And in the spring, and we starts getting in the summer, many fruits we get. Who told the plants this? It's a time to bear the fruit. And who is that intelligence behind all the intelligence? That is Deva. And last week also I mentioned, if something we, at least yoga practitioners, we have to start, if it is a very hot day, never swear at the weathers. Very hot, it's a horrible weather. If it's a cold winter, don't swear at the weather. And try to endure. Tam titikshvastva bharata. And Sri Krishna says, endure, endure. Shitoshna sukadukkeshu. And cold or hot or rain, never swear at the weather. Try to endure. Which is beyond your control. It's obey, not to accept. Many things happens, accept which is beyond your control. This coronavirus is happening. It's we can keep on blaming every day, keep on blaming. But yes, it is beyond my control. All I can do, what I can do. Not it's a blaming, start criticizing everyone in the social media, that country, this country, I have to protect. Now it has gone out of control. How to protect myself? And prayer helps, and pray for the wellness of everyone. That we can do, and not to be critical of everyone. If you are so critical, nobody will want to associate with you. Those will have many friends. They are very thinking, always good for others. They will have many friends. If always person is always critical, always criticizing everyone, one by one drops away. That person will lead a lonely life. And Devad Vijoguru Prajnam. To acquire the knowledge, I have to approach a teacher. Teacher, Dvija. Dvija means not. It's everyone. It's called as the first birth. Everyone that we are born, first birth. And Dvija is the one who has taken interest in learning, not the ordinary thing like others. One which is not seen, which is beyond that one, beyond the sense perception. I want to learn. I want to know about the metaphysical science. Physical science, everyone learns. That person is not called as Dvija. One who starts taking interest in learning the metaphysical science, which is not coming to the cognition of the senses. Like, for example, now you are all attending the Bhagavad Gita class, you are interested in metaphysical science. You are called as Dvija. Respect those people who have taken special interest in learning things which is not big. You can't see that one. You can experience that one. That is called as Dvija. Dvija, one is I am learning. And Guru is the one, not only I am interested in learning, I start imparting that one to the interested people. If I am teaching, say, it's whatever 50, 100 people are attending, that is, I am teaching 50 or 100 and you learn and you pass it on to another 5 people. So, it is you, that chain continues. Water, then knowledge, river of water flow, knowledge of water flows. And this jnana, it starts flowing when you start imparting others, it is called as guru. And respect them, respect the one who is imparting the knowledge. And the prajna means one who has taken interest in learning higher things, one who is imparting to others, and not only imparting, one who has experienced within. Whatever one is speaking, one who has experienced, has an inner experience, that is called as prajna. Prajna, pra means prakrishta, jna means knowledge, one who has a special knowledge. Special knowledge, bookish knowledge I get, yes, I get some sort of information, some knowledge I get, but the real knowledge you get when you start diving deep, it's a new dimension of knowledge opens up. That is called as prajna. Prajna pujanam. Respect them. That is called as the physical tapas. Pujanam shaucham. To do that one, the physical level, the purity. Purity, physical cleanliness. And in Vishnu Sahasranama, it talks about Putatma Paramatma Cha Muktanam Paramangatihi. Putatma, Puta means purity. Putatma, most purest is number 18. Most purest is number 18. That is why people, they are doing tapas to purify themselves so that the most purest be revealed within. Most purest is within. To see that one, we have to remove the impurities. We have to remove the impurities through the sadhana. We have to remove the impurities. When I am sitting, my knees are hurting, my back is hurting. Why it is hurting? Because of impurity, toxins have built up in the body. My back is hurting. Why? Impurities are there. Energy is not flowing properly. And that is because of the impurities, my back hurts, neck hurts, and shoulder hurts. Everywhere it's hurting. Why energy is not flowing? Impurities are built up. Purify, shaucham, and through asana, through yoga, purify, shaucham. Arjavam, straightforward in talking. The seekers of higher knowledge is not having a hidden agenda. Talking a sweet talks. And like in the Facebook, they put in a comment, oh nice, so nice, I haven't read that one, I don't mean that one. Only to impress others, one thumbs up, only to please, I may not mean that one. Straightforward in dealing. In dealing, it's you have to be what you think and your action should align. Arjavam, straightforward, only straightforward dealing, that person. That you have to be upfront, not to have a hidden agenda for getting a personal mileage. And brahmacharya ahimsamcha, brahmacharya, the physical tapas, you need to have a goal for your life. Think big, think great, think auspicious, think big. That what you think you will achieve. If my vision is itself, if I have myopia, very short-sighted person. I can't see long distance. My vision is what I have to, my vision for my life, all I have to do is I only think what is for breakfast, what is for lunch, what is for dinner, that is all is my vision. Nothing beyond that one. What is next meal? What is next meal? And this vision, not only this, for 5 years, where I had to be, 10 years, where I had to be, in 50 years, where I had to be, in the before I enter the death bed, what, where I should have been traveled, covered my distance. We are on a short lifespan. We are on a, it's a short, time is a stopwatch, it is ticking. And any time it can stop, it's on a limited shelf life. We are on a limited shelf life. In this limited shelf life, how best I can travel? How best I can upskill myself? This every day, like electronic gadgets, we upgrade every day. How well I can upskill this one? I don't know when I will get an opportunity to upskill. When I have opportunity, when I have the right place, right surrounding, when I have come across a right teacher. If I miss this opportunity also, how can I expect to find another opportunity? And this brahmacharya, it's a limited shelf life, where I have to be. Think that one. Start, it's extending your vision, longer vision. Brahmacharya, ahimsam cha. When I have a vision to be, to reach that place, before I enter my deathbed, ahimsa, I should not be trodding on someone's head. I don't care, it's what happens to others, I want to reach my goal. Not that one. Be mindful of the co-travelers. Not to be a burden to the co-travelers. Tread your steps very carefully that you are not hurting others. Try to inspire them also into this glorious path. Brahmacharya ahimsam cha shariram tapa uchyate. These are called as the tapas in the physical frame, in the physical level. In the tapas, in the physical level, and in the ahimsa also, as long as we live, for example, the Eid, it's the festival, the significance of that one is a sacrifice the negativity in you. And negativity in you, and instead of that one, we take that one word literally, and we think the sacrifice means only killing some camel or sheep or cow or some chicken and kill them, and I sacrificed. It is not. It's a sacrifice. Sacrifice the negativity. In India also, in the past they used to, and the sacrifice, Nepal, many countries, they are doing that one. They are stopping that one. And here also, I appeal to our Muslim friends also, not to take the sacrifice, not to kill the poor animals. In the name of sacrifice, they are not to be sacrificed, and sacrifice the negativity in you. Try to instill the positive values and not to make a bloodbath by mercilessly killing them. They also have right to live. They also have brothers, sisters, family, and they have a right to exist. Look after them. Ahimsam cha shariram tapa uchyate. And then in the talking level, how I should be in the talking level, the sattvic person, how one has to talk. The 14th one. Deva dvijaguro prajnam. Pujanam shaucha marjavam. Brahmacharya ahimsam cha. Shariram tapa uchyate. Anudvegakaram vakyam. satyam priyahitam chayat
satyam priyahitam chayat
swadhyaya abhyasanam chaiva
swadhyaya abhyasanam chaiva
vangmayam tapa uchyate
vangmayam tapa uchyate.
And in the talking level, how one has to be and not talking with emotion. It's out of control, and after that regretting, I should not have spoken that way. I so upset, I spoke, and opened the lid and I blasted that person. And anudvega karam, not with excitement, whenever you're talking, and have a control over your talk. Udvega with anxiety, with when you charged up, when you're upset, with using all abusive language, have control over your tongue. Anudvega karam, and anudvega karam vakyam, whatever you're talking, it should not upset. Very sharp, it's a control, have a control over your tongue. And those who use abusive language in their talking, they say the divine sanctity in that person depletes. And the divine sanctity, various divine beings take shelter in one who is not using abusive language and very calm person. Anudvega also, and as a yoga practitioner, someone mentioned they burst into anger. They can't control the anger. And after that, they regret. And anger itself is, we do the sadhana. For example, 2 hours of japa we do, our spiritual energy goes up. Spiritual energy goes up, and when I am upset and be very angry when scream at others, my spiritual energy gets depleted. Whatever sadhana I have done, it gets depleted. I can't build up my capacity. Somehow my anger, I can't control. I am a chatterbox. Continuously talking, I don't know how to control. Continuously talking, my spiritual energy goes down. If you want to conserve your spiritual energy and control the emotions, control the emotions. In the scriptures also, many times it comes, and divine beings to test whether this person is has progressed in sadhana, they tempt that person. Like Vishwamitra, when he was he wanted to be called as a Brahma Rishi, he was like Vasishta, he wanted to be called as a Brahma Rishi. He started doing intense tapas, and the divine beings to test his willpower, it's deliberately they sent the nymphs, divine nymphs, and sometimes he used to get very angry and used to curse them. Or Agatsya, he did tapas more than required. Extra spiritual energy has to be depleted. And Indra came and made him to curse. By cursing, if you start cursing others, your energy goes down. Agatsya's extra energy got depleted when he cursed Indra. And Vishwamitra, when he started cursing, his energy comes down. And in your spiritual practice also, many people you will come across in your life and you will swear at them. You go and perish and get lost. And when you start saying that one, it is not only your words, your energy will come down. Your sadhana comes down. Endure the hardship. People start maybe abusing, not to retaliate, endure. Retaliate means not to become like a doormat. Whatever you are saying, you are not angry, but you can show that you are angry. But inside, not to lose the composure. Never curse others. And you, that way you conserve the energy. That is the tapas in the talking level. Manaprasada saumyatvam. ఇట్స్ బిఫోర్ దట్ వన్ అనుద్వేగకరం వాక్యం
అండ్
యు టాక్ సత్యం ప్రియం హితం చయత్ ద ప్రియం అండ్ హితం ద ప్రియా మీన్స్ వాట్ అదర్స్ వాంట్స్ టు హియర్ యు టు ఓన్లీ టాక్ అబౌట్ దట్ వన్ లైక్ ఇన్ ద సోషల్ మీడియా వీఆర్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ కంట్రోల్ we want to comment for each and everything and because we want to be seen as a good person and we want to be seen as a, whether wrong or right I don't care and we want to be seen as a good person priyam and you have to talk the truth and in the priyam it should be pleasing to and it's a pleasing to hear and it should bring in good to others and both Priya and Hita should go together. Not only the Priya and only the politicians behind them. Many people go after them. You are great. You are the best. You are the best. Reason behind I start pampering my boss. I want to please him and always say, yes sir, yes sir. Whatever you say sir, yes sir. Why I want to please him? Priyam. And you had to talk, you had to tell what is right also. Not to be only that pleasing the boss, pleasing the politicians. Like always, yes, yes, you had to the speak, it should bring in good. Good also. Good of that one, not to blindly to please. Only yes, 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 and to get some mileage out of that one. Priyam Hitam and mileage, getting the mileage is called as in the previous one we talked about Arjavam. Arjavam, no mileage, no personal agenda. Priyam Hitam Chayat Swadhyaya Bhyasanam Chaiva and you start getting the control over your tongue and through Swadhyaya. Every day introspect. And redefine how much you have traveled in your life. And introspect and reflect on the scriptures. That is why in our yoga also, I talked many at length. Swadhyaya, make it a point. Every day, read from the scriptures. Ramayana, Bhagavatam, Mahabharata, Bhagavad Gita, Upanishad. Read from these ones. And draw the inspiration. When you start reading, your personality starts shaping up. Personality changes. You start getting the control over your tongue. You start becoming an eloquent speaker. Swadhyaya abhyasanam. Every day you practice. Every day reflect. Reading the scriptures also, not after my meal, after my coffee, I'll read one. Have a practice. After you do that one, with devotion, sit and read. And give the respect, seen some people reading the Bhagavad Gita, reading a coffee in one hand and reading that one. No respect. Give some respect. And respect, with respect, when you are reading the Bhagavad Gita books also, people keep it on the floor and walk around. Don't keep the books, sacred books on the floor. And keep it somewhere high, where people are walking, with the shoes people are walking, you keep the book. Give a respect to that book also you are reading. That is also a sadhana. You keep the book in a special place. Swadhyaya abhyasanam chaiva vangmayam tapa uchyate. These are all called as the tapas in the talking level. Next one. Manaprasada saumyatvam. Maunam atma vinigraha. Bhava samshuddhiritheta.
Tapo manasa uchyate.
The tapas in the mental level. In the physical level we covered. And the talking level we covered. In the thinking level. And manaprasada saumyatvam. Manaprasada. Always calm mind. Serene mind. And the source of happiness or calm mind is within, it's not outside. And many people, they say, my family, and I am very disturbed. I can't tolerate my wife. I can't tolerate my husband. I can't tolerate my boss. I can't tolerate my colleagues. And I can't tolerate my family members. I can't tolerate my society. I can't tolerate other religion. Those who are not agreeing to my religion, I can't tolerate. Why it is disturbing you? You should have a calm mind. If I am saying I can't tolerate, problem is not outside, problem is here. My problem is here. Mana prasada, try to have a calm mind, irrespective of the situation, try to find a peace within. That is sadhana. If everything is good, becoming being happy, it is not a sadhana. The happiness, many advertisement we see, a person drinking a Coke and happy, and wearing a sunglass and showing a happiness, or having a car next to the Mercedes Benz and happy. Is the happiness will be, when if I wear a glass, will I be happy? Or if I drink a Coke, or if a coffee, or a Mercedes Benz, happiness is not outside, happiness is here. Mana, yogi, how? The Satvic happiness in the mind, always happy and serene. Mana prasada saumyatvam, very polite nature, not a very aggressive nature, very gentle nature. The person is very gentle. Mana prasada saumyatvam, maunam atma vinigraha. Maunam, talk sparingly, not a loose talker. The person in the mentioned talking means not only here, in the social media also. Social media, I want to comment for everything. Everything, it is absorb mauna. And in the group also, in the yoga group also, if somebody takes a class, good class, I want to comment. Thank you. Comment only if you are adding value. Don't, it's a burden the social media or clutter the social media. And after the Bhagavad Gita, thank you. Are you conveying any message? How are you adding value? Thank you is not the message. If you want to comment on something, the particular thing you liked and how it can be improved, how it has affected you, you comment on that one. Not just thumbs up, thank you. Be a loose talker. Observe the discipline in the mental level. Mana prasada saumyatvam, maunam atma vinigraha. Maunam, and observe the silence. Talk when required. Then only you start getting the respect. Your value goes up when you start talking when required. Not talk all the time. Convey the message all the time. Maunam atma vinigraha. Atma means senses. Have the control over your senses. Do the asana. Try to sit without moving for 10 minutes, 15 minutes, half an hour. I am asking all the students to sit in Padmasana. Try to practice. Make a sankalpa. I will sit in Padmasana in 10 days time. I will practice and I will sit. Make a sankalpa. To give an example, in BKS Iyengar, he was born in the World War was happening 1914 or around that time. And World War, he was born with pneumonia and he had typhoid and he had asthma problem and one after another. Very sick person, and doctors also said he won't last for 1 or 2 years. A very sick person, always sick. and he approached his teacher and Deshika, it's Krishnamacharya. Krishnamacharya and Krishnamacharya, he when he went to him, his sister's husband, his teacher, and he was so sick, he could not touch his even knee. While standing, he can't bend that much. So rigid, and body was so rigid, and he was he thought it is better to die, BK Iyengar. And Krishnamacharya said, and in Mysore palace, and Maharaja will be there, I want you to give a demonstration, and such a date, get ready. And all he said, that one, something triggered, I can do. He decided, he practiced, and he practiced, and he came out an excellent yoga teacher. And he is also referred as Bhishmacharya of yoga. He revived yoga. He brought yoga to the West. And the West, many Western followers, they are doing. It's a sankalpa, manaprasad, and the willpower. If you want to sit in Padmasana, not to say that I can't. This BK Iyengar, he was counting his last days. He ended up living for 96 years. It's a willpower. And it is where you can reach based on the willpower. Not to say, sorry, I can't do. Sorry, I can't do. And sorry is not an answer. And take the sorry out of your dictionary. And manaprasada saumyatvam maunam atma vinigraha. Have control over your senses. Atma vinigraha. Bhava samshuddhi rityetat bhava. Always try to purify your heart. Whenever you are agitated, disturbed, inquire, why I am upset? Why I am upset? Bhava samshuddhi rityetat tapa manasa uchyate. That is the tapas in the mental level. You have to do the tapas. Tapas. And repeat all three. Tapas in the physical, mental, and talking level. Devadvijaguru prajnam.
Devadvijaguru prajnam.
Pujanam shauchamarjavam.
Pujanam shauchamarjavam.
Brahmacharya ahimsancha.
Brahmacharya ahimsancha.
Shariram tapa uchyate.
Shariram tapa uchyate.
Anudvega karam vakyam.
Anudvega karam vakyam.
Satyam priyahitam chayate.
Satyam priyahitam chayate.
Svadhyaya bhyasanam chaiva.
Svadhyaya bhyasanam chaiva.
Vangmayam tapa uchyate.
Vangmayam tapa uchyate.
Manaprasada saumyatvam.
Manaprasada saumyatvam.
Maunam atma vinigraha.
Maunam atma vinigraha.
Bhava samshuddhi rityetat.
Bhava samshuddhi rityetat.
Tapo manasa uchyate.
Tapo manasa uchyate.
Vasudeva sutam devam.
Vasudeva sutam devam.
Kamsa chanura mardanam.
Kamsa chanura mardanam.
Devaki paramanandam.
Devaki paramanandam.
Krishnam vande jagadgurum.
Krishnam vande